The LS6 can be an incredibly reliable engine to 200, 250,000 plus miles. Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video on the most common GM LS6 engine problems and reliability. The LS6 engine is simply a glorified variant of GM's LS1 engine. Now, there were a lot of updates to the LS6, so it's not totally true just to call it a glorified LS1, but ultimately, these two engines share much of their base design. The LS1 was a very reliable engine, but a lot of these updates that went into the LS6 not only helped it make additional power, but also made it a more reliable engine overall. The LS6 is incredibly reliable and nearly a bulletproof engine, but no engine is truly bulletproof, and that applies here with the LS6 as well. So while it's a very reliable engine, it does still suffer from a number of issues. Number one on the list, we have high oil consumption. This isn't a serious problem and often something that doesn't affect reliability or longevity. However, it's still something to be aware of so that you can check the oil levels and ensure that the LS6 always has proper oil, because what can cause potential serious harm is running the LS6 on low oil, either for extended periods of time or in shorter bursts, especially if you're driving the engine hard and aggressively. Some of the high oil consumption ties into a minor design flaw with the PCV system and valley cover. Outside of that, oil consumption naturally increases with more age and mileage on the engine, especially nowadays with the LS6 being a 20 plus year old engine. But again, I just want to circle back to the point that this really isn't a serious issue and often something that doesn't cause any overall reliability or longevity issues. Oil consumption can be very detrimental. Make a good habit of checking your oil level every couple months or roughly every 500 miles. Moving on to another common problem, at number two on the list, we have oil pump failure. Oil pumps have always been a slightly weaker point on LS engines, not just the LS6. And actually, in the case of the LS6, it does have a stronger and better oil pump than many of the other LS engines. So that is a big benefit to the LS6. However, this is still a potential weak point and something that does occasionally fail on the LS6 engine. So most importantly, rather than always doing this preventatively, it might not be a bad idea if the oil pump has never been addressed before, and especially if you're picking up an LS6 with 100,000 plus miles on it. But more importantly, if you are modifying the engine or ever in the area of the oil pump, it doesn't hurt to go ahead and replace that or upgrade it. And that's especially true if you're intending to use the LS6 aggressively, especially for things like track use. Tying into that, the timing chain is also a little bit weaker on the LS6 compared to some other engines. So that's another good thing to consider if you're modifying, tuning the engine, or planning to drive it aggressively. These are great upgrades and great things to knock out preventatively before they could potentially become serious issues. But outside of that, again, the oil pump and timing chain can be issues, but not usually a major cause for concern, and that's especially true on a stock vehicle. Moving on to the third common problem, we have overheating problems. Sticking with the trend of this video, overheating isn't a major cause for concern and is often not a serious issue on the LS6. If you're driving it moderately, you will rarely run into any overheating issues outside of running into a potential failure, like a radiator issue or a cooling fan issue, water pump problem, etc. So this is once again more targeted to the people who may be looking to tune, modify, and drive the LS6 aggressively. Two of the weaker points on the LS6 are the oil cooler as well as the radiator. So these are two common upgrades for the LS6. Something to keep in mind, especially with the age of the LS6 nowadays, these could be problems on their own. And if you're running into overheating problems, the radiator and oil cooler are going to be two of the best things to address first. That really wraps up the most common problems for the GM LS6 engine, but a couple of other issues that did affect the LS6. There were some problems with the rocker arm bearings as well as broken valve springs. And this mostly affected earlier models, especially 2001. Outside of that, not really major problems or anything to worry about. Now that said, in summary of these common problems and tying that into overall LS6 reliability. As I briefly stated at the start of the video, the LS6 is a very reliable engine and nearly bulletproof. It is an upgrade even over the LS1, which is also a pretty reliable engine overall. Again, quickly circling back through the topics I discussed and pointing out again that these are mostly non-serious issues, just things to address or things that pop up more frequently than others. Starting with the high oil consumption, mostly a non-issue, just keep an eye on those oil levels. When it comes to oil pump failures, the LS6 does have a better oil pump than some of the other LS engines of its generation, but it's still a known weak point and something to address when tuning and modding the vehicle. Same goes for the cooling system and some potential overheating issues. This is mostly a non-problem on stock engines, but if you're starting to modify the LS6, then upgrading the radiator and the oil cooler are also great things to address. So ultimately, if you keep this engine stock and take good care of it, stay on top of oil levels, use quality oils, etc., the LS6 can be an incredibly reliable engine to 200, 250,000 plus miles. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.